on the cello. Vibrato is such a beautiful addition to our playing. Here's a sound without vibrato. And here's with vibrato. We like to say it warms the sound up. I would like to make a special point at first that cello vibrato is slower than violin vibrato. One of the first steps to vibrato learning is the same for violin and cello. Slide your hand up and down the strings. This sliding action gets your arm moving in the direction that vibrato actions move. Vibrato actually is a change of pitch. So as you can tell, if I make sound while I'm doing this, I'm going higher and lower. That's the direction your hand will go when you do vibrato. Now for cello, I like to come, and actually violin, to the shoulder of the instrument and let my thumb stay behind the crook here in the back of the neck and just tap the shoulder with the side of the palm of my hand. That's the angle, that's the direction vibrato should be. It's important there's a rhythmic pulse to it, so I don't know if you can hear this, but it's like pa, 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 pa. That's a nice speed for a vibrato. And then I'll say, hang on to finger two. Doesn't matter where you put it. We're not going to add the bow or sound. Just keep that regular rhythmical swinging tapping. And then add finger three. What you need to be able to do with vibrato is to change from finger to finger without stopping. So this beginning exercise is just a really great one to get that sense. Then I add my pinky, but I always keep a couple fingers together. So you'll notice my first and second finger are not on the string anymore, but I'm still doing my tapping. And then I'll go back to three, release my four. And then I'll go back to two, release my three. And then I come to number one. Number one is often the most difficult finger because your arm can go in a bad angle. Then after this is feeling pretty good, slide your hand back by your head in first position and see if you can keep the same action, the same speed. Roll to one finger, roll to another finger. The other thing that's happening behind the neck, let me just show you, is when I change from finger to finger, my thumb is under the finger that I'm vibratoing. So in essence, it looks like this, but the neck is in between. The thumb and the finger are making a circle with the neck when I do vibrato. So there has to be a real buoyant, free feeling in your hand so your thumb can move and your fingers can vibrato and go from note to note. Just a little side note, vibrato is not pumping the arm up and down. This does not make a change of pitch. It has to be the direction of the string. That's super slow, just to show you the example of it. And vibrato does have different speeds. So here's a slow vibrato that's acceptable. And we could go quicker for more exciting music. But cello vibrato doesn't ever go this fast. I call that the mosquito twitch. Don't do that. So cello vibrato is a nice big swing. Start by sliding, come down here and tap the shoulder of your instrument, and then just hang from finger to finger. It will come to you, I promise, and it's a beautiful addition to your playing. Thank you very much.